going to solve some linear inequalities. Now, solving an inequality is just like solving an equation. We find what values of the variable make the inequality work. And our key strategy is going to be the same as it was back for solving equations. Isolate the variable. Now here, it's the 3 that's bothering the x. We're just going to subtract 3 from both sides to isolate the x. And we can do that because if you subtract the same thing from both sides of an inequality, well, the larger side stays larger than the smaller side. Subtracting the 3 cancels out the 3 on the left, and we're left with x is greater than 5 minus 3, which is 2. And that's all there is to it. This is a perfectly fine solution. It tells us that every value of x that's greater than 2 works in this inequality. You can go ahead and test it. You can stick some in. Put in 3. 3 plus 3 is 6. That's greater than 5. That works. Put in 7. 7 plus 3 is 10. That works too. If I put in something less than 2, put in 0. 0 plus 3 is 3. 3 is not greater than 5. What if I put in 2? 2 plus 3 is 5. 5 isn't greater than 5. 5 is equal to 5. So 2 doesn't work. And our inequality here tells us that. X greater than 2. Our solution tells us x has to be greater than 2. Can't equal 2. We can also graph on the number line. Just plot on the number line the values of x that work. So we have our number line here. We have 0, 1, 2, 3, and so on. And we want the part of the number line that's greater than 2. So we're going to just shade all the number line that's larger than 2. We're even going to shade the arrow out here just to show that we just keep going and going and going. But at 2, 2 isn't a solution. We know that 2 is not a solution, so we want to indicate that. We're going to put a little circle there. A big circle there says we're going to start at 2. We're not including 2. And then we're going to go to the right. And that's what all this shading is over here. And that shows us that our solution is all the numbers greater than 2. All right, we've got that down. Let's try another one. And right away, we see a difference between this one and the last one, this little line under the inequality. That tells us that the two sides are allowed to be equal as well. So the right side could be larger, or the two sides could be equal. And once again, we're going to isolate the variable, and we're going to do that first by combining all the variable terms. We're going to move the 3m over to the left side. We're going to subtract 3m from both sides, because we're allowed to subtract the same thing from both sides of an inequality. Now 5m minus 3m, that gives us 2m. And that'll be less than or equal to negative 10. The 3m's on the right cancel. And now we can divide both sides by 2, just like we can multiply both sides of an inequality by a positive number. We can divide both sides of an inequality by take half the smaller side is still going to be less than or equal to half the larger side. And this tells me that our answer, our solution here, is just m is less than or equal to negative 5. So all the numbers from negative 5 on down work for m. Now, the difference between this and last time is that negative 5 works as well. That's what that line right there tells us. And we can test this. We can stick negative 5 in here. 5 times negative 5 is negative 25. Over on the right, 3 times negative 5 is negative 15. Minus 10 is negative 25. Sure enough, the two sides are equal, and we're allowed to have them equal. So negative 5 is a solution. But if we tried something greater than negative 5, like 0, we'll get 0 on the left, negative 10 on the right. 0 is not less than or equal to negative 10. So 0 is not a solution, and our inequality here tells us this. Our solution, m less than or equal to negative 5, tells us that 0 can't possibly work. And of course, we can plot this on the number line as well. Start at negative 5, negative 4 to the right, negative 3. Go in the other direction, we have negative 6, then negative 7. Now this time, our solutions, they go to the left. M is less than or equal to negative 5. So I'm going to start at negative 5, and I'm going to go this way. Come to left, come to the left. Shade the arrow to say we just keep going and going and going. Now this time we're going to do something a little different. At negative 5, we're going to make a big solid dot. And that says include the negative 5 this time, because negative 5 works. All right, so we got that. We have one more. One more. And, oh, this one's a little bit trickier. All right, the first thing I like to do when I see these fractions, I like to get rid of the fraction. I try to wipe out the fraction here. And when we were dealing with equations, we did that by just multiplying by the denominator. We'll do the same thing here. We're going to multiply both sides by 3, and that'll knock out this denominator. So we'll have 3 times 2 times 2 minus c is greater than or equal to negative 2 plus c all over 3, multiplying by 3. And we're allowed to multiply both sides of an inequality by a positive number. We'll cancel the 3's. Over here, 3 times 2 is 6. We have 6 times 2 minus c is greater than or equal to negative 2 plus c. All right, so over here, what do? Distribute this out, we get 12 minus 6c is greater than or equal to negative 2 plus c. Now, once again, we want to get all the variable terms on one side and all the constant terms on the other, just like we did with equations. So we're going to subtract c from both sides. That'll get all the variables over here. And I'm going to subtract 12 from both sides. And that's going to get all the constant terms over there. That's going to give me negative 7c is greater than or equal to minus 2 minus 12 is minus 14. Well, now I've got to divide by negative 7. I have to be careful here. We learned before that if you multiply by a negative number, if you multiply an inequality by a negative number, then you have to flip the inequality sign. 2 is greater than 1, but negative 2 is less than negative 1. So when I divide by 7 here, I'm going to divide by negative 7. I'm going to divide both sides by negative 7. The negative 7's cancel, and I have c is less than or equal to 2. So this works just like multiplication. Division is multiplying by a reciprocal. So when I divide by negative 7, just as if I multiplied by negative 7, I have to flip the inequality symbol from greater than or equal to less than or equal to. And again, we can test our answer. If we put 2 up in this inequality, if I put 2 in here, I'm going to get 0 on the left and 0 on the right. And that's okay. They're allowed to be equal. Now, what happens if I pick something less than or equal to 2? And this is why checking your inequality is so important. If I put 0 in here, for example, this tells me that 0 is going to work. I put 0 in up there for c. I have 2 times 2 is 4. And over there I get negative 2/3. 4, of course, is greater than or equal to negative 2/3. If I'd forgotten to flip my inequality, this check would have reminded me. This check would have said, hey, you messed up. Because that would have said greater than or equal to 2. And then when I tested 0, I would expect it not to work. But when I put 0 in here for c, it works, just like this tells me. So my solution is c is less than or equal to 2. And we see that our strategy for solving linear inequalities is basically the same thing as solving linear equations. Isolate the variable, then check your answer.